He's still working according to His word. You stop speaking His word, He stops working. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 23:28, He that has my word, let him that has my word speak it faithfully. For it is not my word like a fire and like a hammer. Is not my word. Let him speak it faithfully. Why? He works in line with His word. Say, God works in line with His word. Now, here's the other thing we were singing. He's faithful. You know what? He's faithful to His word. One time there was a lady, Donald, that was trying to be healed. She had Brother Hagin pray, and everyone prayed for her, and she couldn't get her healing. He says, why don't you just say, by His stripes I'm healed? She said, I can't, because I'm not. And then the guy said, can you thank Him for His word? Well, yeah, I can thank Him for His word. So he said, well, just start thanking Him that 1 Peter 2:24 is working for you. And she got healed in about 3 days. Why? Because He's faithful to His word. Say this, God is faithful to His word. God is faithful to a person that will speak His word. He works according to His word. You just go, thank You, Lord, You're faithful to Your word. Thank You, Lord, You're faithful to give me strength. When I confess, let the weak say I'm strong. When I say I'm strong, You're faithful to Your word. He's faithful to His word. He says, I watch over my word to perform it. No word of mine that goes forth out of my mouth will return void, because I'm faithful to that word. I'm faithful to my word. God is faithful to His word. He is faithful to His word. I hear this. Give me some word. Give me some word. Give me some word. Give me, give me, give me. God is saying, give me, give me, give me. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. You got something there? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to Donald. Come down here and have us sing a little bit in the spirit. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Lift your voice. Glory. Oh, hallelujah. 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 I keep hearing that again. I keep hearing that again. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Gimme, gimme, gimme. And then I hear this. You can't overload me with the word. You can't overload me with the word. You cannot overload me with the word. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Give me the word. Give me my word. Return unto me my word. So shall my word be. So shall my word be. So shall my word be that goes forth. That goes forth. Notice it goes forth. It goes forth. So shall my word be that goes forth. It'll not return void. It will accomplish that which you set it out. Set it out. If you set it out for healing, it'll accomplish that. If you set it out for prosperity, it'll do that. Glory to God. 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 Glory, Terry. Step out here. Step out here. I heard this morning praying. You do. Look at me. The believing. Not me. God says, you do the believing and I'll do the doing. You do the believing and I'll promote you. But you have to do the believing. If thou canst believe, you do the believing and God will do the doing. You do the believing and leave the doing to Him. Got that? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Well, praise God. Well, praise God. In a little bit, you got that song you're going to sing? Huh? Okay. So I'd like to have maybe the one, You're So Good to Me. Not right now, but after a while. We do that? Glory to God. Everybody, hallelujah. You may be seated. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You know, I was going to say, we're doing a little bit different today. But somebody would think already, well, you always do something different. As much as God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, He's just changing the way He does the service. Because He's the same. Hallelujah. Did you get that? You do the believing, He'll do the doing. Because Psalm says, now I know it talks about a certain thing, but promotion comes from the Lord. Are you here today? Hallelujah. How many of you love Jesus? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. He's a good God. He loves us. He cares for us. And He's saying that again. It's in me again. Gimme, gimme, gimme. You can't overwhelm me by giving me the word.
Amen.
I mean, when I first got saved and I was going to ask the Lord about something, I said, oh my God, He's got all these people that really have a need. I don't want to overwhelm Him. My God, overwhelm God. How silly.
Yeah.
Huh?
That's right.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, thank God we're renewing our thinking, aren't we?
Yes.
You know, we think, can God handle this? My God, He's upholding everything right now, so I reckon a little bit more on His plate ain't going to overwhelm Him, is it?
Right.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
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 Glory to God. So, go to Mark chapter 16. Praise God. Hallelujah. Anyway, was praying this morning, some things just were coming to me to share. Mark 16, verse 17. It says, and these signs shall follow them. Them who? Them that believe. You know, there's too many people in the body of Christ going around following signs. But God wants signs to follow us. In fact, what do believers do? Are we believers? What do we believe? That signs follow us. I mean, you know, are you a believer? Well, I think so. You better find out so.
Yeah.
These signs shall follow them that
believe.
Believe. You know what? Put it up there in the Greek. Darren, did you get it in there? Signs, listen to this. The ones believing these will follow the name of me. Demons will be expelled. Them that follow me, the believing. Do you see the believing?
Yeah.
Here's a better translation. Signs follow the believing ones.
Yeah. Yeah.
The believing ones. If you're believing, well, I believed. Well, that was good. You did believe, but it's better if you're believing. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
You see that, Rebecca? These signs follow the believing ones.
Yes. Yes.
These signs follow the believing. The ones believing. Look at the ones believing. These what signs will follow? In the name of me, demons, they will expel.
Yes.
I come to believe that a lot of people, the reason they don't see victory over spirits is they don't believe that them spirits will have to go because they're believers.
That's right.
The ones believing. The ones believing. One time there was this lady, there was a minister down in Houston, I think he was at John Osteen's church, some meetings, and a lady come up to this one minister that was there out in the parking lot, and he was going, she started talking to him about her healing. He said, well, you got to use your faith. She said, well, I have faith. He said, that's what's wrong. You have it. Good. You got to release it.
Yes.
Believing. What do believers do?
Believe.
What do they believe?
The word.
They believe these signs. Say signs
follow
the believing ones.
The believing ones.
Not those that have believed, the believing ones. John chapter 11, verse 40. This come to me again today when I was praying too. Jesus said unto her, they was at Lazarus' grave. And he says, he'll rise again. She said, I know in the resurrection. Jesus said, I am the resurrection. Hallelujah. Glory. Jesus said, I am the resurrection. Glory be to God. And then he said unto her, say I not unto thee, if thou wouldest,
believe.
What?
Believe.
If thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God. Hallelujah. God started stirring that up in me again, because I used to walk this sanctuary and I'd say, I believe to see the glory. 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 Jesus, you said if I would believe, I would see the glory. Well, one night we're having service here and the glory showed up. And I thought, what is that? You know, and you weren't even here. And I said, and the glory showed up there. And I said, I was sharing that testimony of it one day. And I says, I don't know, the glory just showed up. And when I got back to the hotel room, the Lord said, you were saying, I believe to see the glory. What do you think it's going to do? You know what we need to do? We need to believe what we say and then say what we believe. Thank God it was coming out of my heart. I mean, the glory. I think, and there's the firemen come. And Brother Hagin was talking about the glory. Because it showed up in Minnesota the night before. And here come the firemen. Lights flashing, I could see through the window. I thought, must have been an accident out there. Wonder God didn't say, what have you been believing for? Well, so I go out in the foyer and these two firemen come with a big, long fire truck. And they're tall anyway, and they got them uniforms on. And they said, what's going on here? I said, what do you mean, what's going on here? He said, well, somebody called from down the street and saw smoke coming out of the building. Duh, you know. And then for a little bit we talked, and they said, well, let me go check it out. So they walk through, and they come back. And I says, oh, my, it come to me, folks. Oh, I think I know what it is. I believe I know what it is. What? I said, the man's teaching about the glory, and it's probably the glory. And one of the firemen standing there said, is this a Pentecostal church? I said, yes, it is. He said, probably so. Glory to God. You need to believe what you say. I probably wasn't believing in my head. Thank God for having it in my heart, because the glory, if... Did he not say? He's telling you today. Am I not telling you? If you'll believe, you'll see. Yes. Say it. Believing is seeing. But we're not. We're spiritual. But the world is seeing is believing. But in the kingdom of God, believing is seeing. You're not going to see it till you believe it. If you saw it before you believed it, that wouldn't please God, because faith pleases God. Are you here today?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I mean, just instead of complaining about certain things during the day, just say, I believe to see the glory. I believe to see the glory. He's stirring that up in me this morning again. To believe him, to see the glory. You want to see the glory? Well, then you start believing to see the glory. You want to see the glory? Do you really want to see the glory?
Yes.
Then don't believe for me to believe to see the glory. You want to see the glory? Then you're going to have to believe.
I believe and to see the glory.
You want to hear the rest of the story? I come to the church a little earlier to talk to a couple in our church about something. And then I come in here and I'm sitting there and I've got my arms up on the pew and I'm thinking, You know, if I didn't have to come to talk with them, I could have probably stayed home. And then the glory showed up. Dear Jesus, I'm glad I had to come. Say this. I just heard this inside of me. Say this. I'm always in the right place, at the right time, when the glory shows up. Just think, that's like he's saying earlier, gimme, gimme, gimme. He that has my word, that he speaks it faithfully, is not my word like a hammer. God, we got to give him faith. Yes. Saying, I believe
to see
the glory. Go to Mark chapter 9, verse 22. Hallelujah. And oft time, this is the dad that had this son, and he was the demons were harassing him. Oftentime it has cast him into the fire and under the waters to destroy him. But look here. This is the dad. But if thou canst do anything, he's talking to Jesus. But if you can do anything, Jesus, have compassion on us and help us. He's saying to Jesus, if you can do anything, Jesus. How many times have we done that? Jesus, if you can do anything, help me out. Jesus, if you can do anything, get the right woman for me to marry. And the Lord said, well, if you do something. Look at the next verse. And Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible. All things are possible. All things are possible. You know there's not a period there?
Right.
To him. You got that in the Greek, Darren? Oh, the Greek is really stuff. Listen to what the Greek says. And Jesus said to him that if thou canst, all things are possible to the one believing. So he's saying, you're saying, if thou canst help us. And Jesus said, if thou canst, all things are possible to the one believing. All things are possible to the one believing. You got to crank up your believing. But don't just believe. Mark 11, 24. For verily I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe, 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 and you shall have them. Believe and you shall have them. Believe and you shall have them. Believe that you and you shall have them. Remember Brother Hagin laying in the bed, he said, I had nobody. Nobody was preaching faith or anything. And he said, it dawned on me one morning, you got to believe before you receive. And then Brother Hagin said, I've got to believe that I'm healed before that I'm going to see that I'm healed. And Jesus said to him, if thou canst. See, the guy said, if you can, do something to help us. And Jesus said, if thou canst, all things are possible to the one that if thou canst believe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The believing ones, the believing. The believing. The believing. The believing. The believing. Glory to God. Well, I believe. Well, keep on believing. But make sure you're saying. You know, I believe if I eat this food, I won't starve to death. I believe if I eat this food, I won't starve to death. I believe if I eat this food, I won't starve to death. And the guy starves to death. Why? He didn't eat food. Now that dad said, if you can do anything, Jesus. Sometimes we're, Jesus, if you can do anything. Well, my brother and sister, I need to remind you and myself, he's done everything.
Right.
It ain't him doing anything.
Amen.
It's us doing our thing.
That's
right. If thou canst believe. All things are possible to him that believes. Mark chapter 5. We're going to honor Pastor Darlene a little bit here, but we'll get to that. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Mark chapter 5. Verse 34. Way to go, Darren. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith has made thee whole. Now, he's not just talking about her health. He said her faith made her whole. Her faith made her whole. Listen to this. The world today. The world today is fragmented. But your faith will open the door to get everything you need to make you whole. Spirit, soul, body, financially, and socially. The world is fragmented, but your faith will open the door to make you whole. Spirit, soul, body, financially, and socially. God wants us whole in every area of our life. And he's already provided for healing, prosperity, whatever it is. Our faith will, your faith and my faith will open the door to get everything that makes spirit, soul, body, financially, socially whole.
Amen.
Isn't that good, honey? And notice he said, her faith. You know, you probably, if any of you listen very much to Brother Hagin, you probably heard how he had to deal with that because he was told healing had been done away with. And the Lord led him to there and he said, did you notice it was her faith that made her whole? And he said to Brother Hagin, faith hasn't been done away with because if faith was done away with, people couldn't get saved. So even if healing was done away with, he used his faith, he could get whole. Oh, that's good. Yeah.
Amen.
Your faith will make you whole. Well, I don't need healing. I'm not talking about healing. I'm talking about life in abundance to the full till it overflows. Spirit, soul, body, financially and socially, every area of your life. Jesus said, I have come that you might have life. Number one, Zoe life, the life of God. And have it more in abundance to the full till it overflows. And your faith will open the door so you can have life in abundance to the full till it overflows. Spirit, soul, body, financially and socially. And that's why, you know, Paul even prayed it. We talked about it Wednesday night. Paul prayed it in 1 Thessalonians 5:23. And I pray that God preserve your whole spirit, your whole soul, and your whole body blameless till the coming of the Lord. Paul prayed that, brother and sister, and Paul got his prayers answered. So if he prayed that for me, bless God, I know my spirit, my soul, and my body's preserved till the coming of the Lord. Blameless. Sickless. Not sick. Sick less. Healthy more. But we have to, in that Ben Campbell rendition, he says, upon doing the appropriate things ahead, in everything give thanks, praying always, walking in love, God will preserve your whole spirit, your whole soul, and your whole body. There's things we have to do. We have to be thankful in everything. We have to pray always. We have to be kind toward one another. And then we do those things, God will preserve our whole spirit, our whole soul, and our whole body for the blameless. The Lord arrested me one day because I was confessing, my God and my Father preserves my whole spirit, my whole soul, my whole body for the coming of the Lord. And the Lord said, don't forget, blameless. But you can't read that scripture and say, oh, that's nice, and shut your Bible up. You got to give action. When you give your action, he gives the reaction. He'll react to your action. Hallelujah. So praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, praise Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, let's honor the Lord with our giving. Amen. Amen. Genesis chapter 7, I believe it is. Thank God for markers in the Bible. I used to have a Bible that had two of these. Now, I don't know if it's because of what it is. You just get one in it. 8. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. Genesis chapter 8, verse 22. While the earth remaineth. Let me ask you something. Is the earth still the earth?
Yes.
Is it still remaining?
Yes.
Then these things are true. Right?
Right.
Seed time. Now, I've told you this before. Seed time. That's not one word. They made it one word, but it's not. Seed, time, and harvest. Not seed time and harvest. Seed time. Seed time. You know, we would sow. I grew up on the farm, and we would sow in October. We would sow the wheat in October, and June and July we'd harvest. Seed time. Seed time. Time. Everybody say seed, time, harvest will remain. Seed, time, and harvest. Seed, cold and heat, is that right? You know, them people in Florida, they don't know. They just way south, I think they have it all the time. But praise God, living in Kansas, you get seed time, you get winter, and you get cold and heat, summer and winter, don't you? Hallelujah. We're living in the right place. We're scriptural. Yeah. Hallelujah. Seed. Seed. Here's another word for time. Seed. Patience. Harvest. Seed. Patience. Harvest. It takes time. It takes time. Remember this. Sometimes, I'm not being negative, sometimes it might take longer to get a return on your harvest because it's got to come through people. And sometimes God has to work with more than one person. Let me tell you about Dr. Savelle. He was in Fort Worth and flying to out east to minister, and he wanted to bless a pastor in Little Rock, Arkansas. Wasn't happy, somebody else. And he had the money, but he flew over and he forgot about it. So the Lord reminded him. So coming back, and he forgot it again, and he forgot it two or three times. And you know what the Lord said to him? He said, that's how people are going to give back to you, how you give to him. You know what he did? He said, fire up my airplane. I'm going to Little Rock right now. When God prompts you to give to somebody or something or whatever, you need to do it because that's how the people are going to give it back to you. I remember that, honey. You remember? Remember that? He'd fly over. He kept forgetting. But that didn't change the cycle. You know, we would say, well, Lord, you know, I forgot. You know, no, the laws don't change. And now that's what the Lord, how you're doing to others is how they're going to do to you. Man, you're prompted to give, do something. Why? Because then God prompts somebody else and they'll give it to you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Seed. Say it. Seed.
Seed.
Time.
Time.
Harvest.
Harvest.
Go ahead. You need to see below? Seed time. It's seed time, folks.
Yes.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. So when you sow your seed, you begin to thank the Lord that harvest is coming to me. And you water that seed and God will bring the increase. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, praise the Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Are you ready to give?
Yes.
Go ahead and receive. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Say, I'm a believer,
I'm a believer.
And not a doubter.
Not a doubter.
Say, I'm a believing one.
I'm a believing one.
Say, I'm a believing one.
I'm a believing one.
What was Brother Willis' book? Oh, I know. Born to Believe. Yeah, if you got that, you might want to take it off the shelf and dust it off a little bit. Hallelujah. Born to Believe. Born to Believe. Hallelujah. So anyway, would the praise team come down here? And we're going to, this was Pastor Darlene's favorite song. Hallelujah. You know what it is they're going to sing? Okay. Go ahead. Abraham's blessing.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
Pastor requested a song, and we could not find a rendition that was fit. We'll put it that way. So we kind of changed the melody and put this together. And I don't know, do you want people to enter in? Because it sure is a good confession.
Yeah, they can. We're singing, Abraham's blessings are mine. Abraham's blessings are mine. And I leaned over to Pastor Darlene and I said, would you marry me? And she started singing loud, Abraham's blessings are mine. Abraham's blessings are mine. Abraham's blessings are mine. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. You can... No, we'll do the other one after a while. Maybe. We'll see. So that's why I had you sing that. Because we were singing Abraham's blessings. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
We were singing Abraham's blessings are mine. And I just, I said, would you marry? What a way to propose. But Abraham's blessing. Glory to God. You mean Abraham's blessings are yours is not romantic?
It's not romantic.
Oh, the occasion.
10,000 people.
But you said yes.
I did. I said yes.
No, you didn't.
She said, yeah.
No.
Said, yes, yes, yes.
Yeah. I said, would you marry me? She said, yes, yes, yes. And then start saying, Abraham's blessings are mine. Abraham's blessings are mine.
I need you to ask me again because I wanted to be sure I heard it right.
And Todd was there, too.
Yeah.
Right? He's not saying anything. And, boy, she really starts singing Abraham's blessing. No, it wasn't very romantic. We went out one night on a... Oh, Jesus. I don't think we ever went on a date. And I had a Pontiac convertible, red Pontiac convertible, and it had a council and bucket seats. And we went out, not on a date, but we went out to talk.
Yeah.
And I had 8 or 9 Bibles in that council between the bucket seats. You know, that was my protection. You know? Do you remember that?
I do. Which was just fine.
Huh? So anyway, Matthew chapter 7, verse 11. The Lord showed me this the other day. If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more? Everybody say it. How much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good things to them that ask Him? I was believing God for a mate that would love God as much as I love God. I didn't care if they could cook, make beds, or whatever. Just love God. Well, God did more than that. He brought someone to me that loved God at that time more than I loved God. I loved God a lot, but some of my love was information knowledge, and hers was revelation knowledge. She loved God more, and this is what the Lord said, because she knew me longer than you've known me. So He, how much more? How much more? He brought somebody into my life. I mean, I love God with all my, right, honey? But He brought someone that loved Him more than me. How much more? How much more? How much more? Folks, how much more? I mean, you being evil, not evil, but we being natural, know how to give good gifts. Did we give good gifts to you, Todd, when you were growing up? he's joshing me now. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, if you only knew, folks. But if we being evil know how to give good gifts, how much more? You got to get in your thinking. How much more? So when we met, and I knew I was going to marry her, she loved God more than I did because she is serving God more. I mean, she might have been a little Catholic girl growing up, deal, but she loved God. And not only that, in fact, a few years ago, it was like, man, God is 100 miles away or something. And I'd go in and I'd ask her, I said, How do you know God's there? And she would just say, she said, I always knew he was there. Didn't you tell me that? She said, I always knew. She wasn't a big word person at the time, but she knew the Lord was present. And I was going through, I said, how do you know? And she'd say, well, you just know. Amen. And I'd say, how do you know? You just know. Remember that? She just knew. I mean, I don't think she ever was a time she didn't know. You always knew.
God was always with me.
And then I'm asking the Lord. I mean, that's what the Lord showed me. He says, how much more? I'm not going to go there. So then I said, Lord, I was talking to the Lord. I said, Lord, how could Todd want me for his dad and he didn't know me? He didn't really know me. At that time, you didn't really know me. And you know what the Lord said? He knew me. And didn't you have a dream or something that I was going to... What was that?
He had a dream that we were going to get married.
So...
And he says, when are you going to get married? And I said, he has to ask me first. And Todd says, why don't you ask him? And I said, well, that's not the way it works. And he says, well, why not? And I says, well, when you get older, you'll understand.
So anyway, that's what the Lord said. He knew me. Yeah. He knew that I wouldn't betray him. I wouldn't. He knew me. Mm-hmm. And he didn't need to know you that well. He knew me. Glory to God. God, so awesome.
Amen.
Glory. Mm-hmm. Glory. So we're singing, Abraham's blessings are mine. Now I'm getting real bold. Man, I'm confessing by faith. Bless God. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it. My legs were shaking. Oh, my God. What are you fixing to do, you know? You better run out of here, buddy. I mean, your free days are about ready to be. Oh, my God. You won't be able to sing, I'm free at last. I'm free at last. Oh, my God. And I just turned up. We're singing, Abraham. I just turned, would you marry me? And she said, what did you say? I said, you mean I got to say it again? And I said, would you marry me? She said, yes, yes, yes. Abraham's blessings are mine. Abraham's blessings are mine in the morning, at night, and all the time. And then later on, I'm thinking, my God, what did I just do? And then Pastor Darlene had to tell Todd. And so they're somewhere in the auditorium. And Pastor Darlene told Todd, Jerry asked me to marry him. So that afternoon, we're sitting there waiting for the afternoon session or something. We're sitting there. Todd's probably coloring or something. He always had something he was doing. He looked over at me and said, Mom told me you. I thought, oh, my God, now he's told her him. Now she's told him. That's two people. What am I going to do?
You know, when I told him what you said, he says, it's about time.
You know, what can I do? You know? What can I do? And praise God. Hallelujah. It's been awesome. Shall I tell them what you said this morning?
I don't remember. That's probably not.
Oh, it's funny.
Okay.
You get a good laugh out of it. So I got up this morning, I went in, I was saying, honey, I said, good morning. I said, this is happy anniversary. She said, oh, that's right, happy anniversary. And I said, this evening. Because we didn't get married till 7 o'clock or so. So we weren't married yet 25 years ago this morning. 45 years ago. So anyway, I said, honey, I said, are you as excited today as you was 45 years ago? She said, well, I'm excited that we're still together after 45 years. Now, you understand what she's saying. Because it's been like heaven on earth. For me. But this morning you were really going for it. They already know that.
Yeah.
We talked about that the other night.
Oh, okay.
You know, when we get up in the morning, I say, are you awake? She'd be up. Are you awake? Well, not really. I say, okay, I won't say anything until you get up. But when I wake up, I'm like, ooh, ye, glory to God, let's go for it. I'm ready to have a revival. Hallelujah. But God is so good. He brought the perfect one for me. Go to Genesis chapter 2, verse 18. In the Amplified Bible. Put it up there in the Amplified Bible. Now the Lord God said, it is not good, sufficient, satisfactory that a man should be alone. And look at here. This really blessed me. I will. God says, I will do something about that. Isn't that good, Florence?
Yes.
Isn't that good, James? Notice, it's not good, so I'm going to do something. Yes. I will. God Almighty says, I will. I will make him a help meet suitable, adaptable, complementary for him.
Amen.
For him. I was talking to Pastor Darlene. I says, God didn't say I'll make that help meet perfect. He says, I'll make that help meet perfect for you. Mm-hmm. For me. For my personality. For my dear. God said he would do that. Mm-hmm. James, do you see that? That is so powerful. That God says, I will. Mm-hmm. He didn't say, I'll have a committee come. Mm-hmm. He didn't say, I'll have the angels do it. He said, I will make someone a help meet suitable, adaptable, and complementary. Now, you see the word adaptable? Pastor Darlene's very adaptable, especially when it comes to sports. She is so adaptable, she'll let me go downstairs and watch them sports all day on that big screen and won't say nothing. She's adaptable. She adapts to that. Right, Lloyd? Is that what Kathy does? I will make him a helper meet. A help meet. A helper. Look at here. Suitable, adaptable, and complementary for him. And that's what the Lord has done for me. The word suitable, competent, masterful, proficient, skilled. The word suitable is skilled, masterful, competent, proficient. Adapted, one of the definitions for the word adapted, all around. Honey, all around. Fluid, versatile. And then complementary, serving to fill out or complete. I was incomplete until God brought you to me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory, thank you. Thank you for
saying yes.
Saying yes. You know, listen to this, folks. I'm telling you, less than 1 year, I wouldn't even say 1 year, And God was able to direct my steps to Michigan from Kansas to find the perfect mate for me that God had for me. Less than a year. Don't tell me you can't be led by God, because you can't. I had to go to Michigan to find the perfect mate for me. But not only that, I had to go to Michigan to find the perfect mate for me. Todd had to go from Michigan to Kansas to find the perfect mate for him. Praise God. Hallelujah. So if I'd have flubbed up, man, he had to come from Michigan to Kansas. I had to go from Kansas to Michigan, and then Todd had to come from Michigan to Kansas. Glory to God. And because he did, he got the perfect mate for him, just like I got the perfect mate for me, because God said, I will.
Amen.
Those words, honey, those words, I will. I will. That's how much God loved me. That's how much God loves you.
Amen.
To get the perfect mate for you. Yes. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, look at this word here. For. See that word for?
Mm-hmm.
It means to reach. For him. To reach him. To attain. To attain. For me to attain what I need to attain. God made the perfect mate for me. For me to attain. For him. For him. That the man should be. I will make him a helpmate for him. For him to attain what he needs to attain in life. Hallelujah. Are you here today?
Yes.
Now, I could say it like this. It's for those that desire to be married.
Mm-hmm.
There's some that I just, well, I don't know if I didn't desire to be married for a while. It was just, but praise God.
Amen.
Thank you for yielding to God. Now, let me tell you, I told the people Wednesday night, I'll tell you those that weren't here Wednesday night. Talk about faith. This woman had faith. She was going to FCF when school, and you were involved there. Todd was going to school there,
sort of
Faith
school.
Christian Academy. Yeah. And you and Pastor Buddy walked up to her and says, what are you going to do when you get through, finish school?
When you graduate, yeah.
When you graduate, what are you going to do? And this is what she told him. I'm going to get married, but he hasn't asked me yet.
I'm supposed to get married.
I'm supposed to get married, but he hasn't asked me yet. Now, that's faith. I mean, that's the come along. I mean, you know, I'm supposed to get married, but he hasn't asked me yet. Well, you heard the rest of the story. We were talking one day, and she said, God told me we are going to get married. And I said, God can put my mail in my own mailbox. And you know what she said? You need to check your mail.
Your mailbox.
Your mailbox.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. 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 So, Rebecca, come up here. I suppose there's something that you can say to Pastor Darling that you're thankful about.
Yeah.
For her.
I am very thankful for you. You know, I think I was maybe 3 or 4 when we first started coming here, and I've watched you, how you've stayed married to him, stayed faithful and true to him, and it's been an example to me. So I am very grateful. You know, that's a lot of years of being married for our pastors, and not only being married, but being our pastors. You know, I've watched you go through a lot, and I've watched you stand And I've watched you be faithful. And it's a great honor for you to be my pastors. So I love you.
Hallelujah. Anybody else? Don't everybody come down here at once. Donald? It's to her.
I left here twice, once out of the will of God, when I went to the other church where, in the black neighborhood. And I remember every time I was gone, every now and then Pastor Darlene would call. Don, we just want to know how you're doing. Huh. We want you to know that we love you. And we're thinking about you. It was always my lifeline to this church. I remember when I was here before, and it was always Pastor Jerry and Darlene, and so we called her Darlene because everyone called her Darlene. When I came back, that was probably one of the things. It was not a big challenge for me. But the more I watched her, I saw the anointing on her life. She was a different person. There was just a greater anointing, and I thought, whoa, yes, she is Pastor Darlene. It's very easy. For me to call you Pastor Darlene. I love you, Pastor Darlene.
Good. Jordan? Hallelujah.
Let's see. There's a lot I could say about my grandma. Let's see here. Well, I'll just say this because it's true. I know a lot of grandparents like their grandkids, but no grandma loves their grandkid as much as my grandma loves me. She's, I mean, I'm just very thankful and grateful for you and we've had a lot of fun over the years. We still have a lot of fun. We always played games and did all kinds of puzzles and cards and dice, and we still do that stuff today. And it's just, we watched Balto a lot, you know, as a kid. But yeah, I don't know. I love you. We took a lot of trips. We talked a lot for hours and hours and still do that and laughed till we cried. Made up songs, sang songs, all that good stuff. But, yeah, I don't know. I'm just blessed to have you as my grandma. And if you could trade in a grandma, which is messed up, I don't know. But I would never trade you in for anyone. So I love you. Yes, you're welcome. Happy anniversary.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'll tell you more about how much he loves his grandma. A few days ago, he said, Grandma, we need to go out and eat. And so they went out to eat, and I did something else, you know. So it was just him and Grandma, you know. Hallelujah. Terry and Audrey.
You always want me to stand back here. Okay.
No, you don't have to stand behind it.
Okay. It's an honor thing. Okay, so I'm thankful to Pastor Darlene because there are many times that you prayed for Terry, and he's more quiet. Well, I wasn't talking about that. Like, he had an accident one day going to work where they had to go through those turnstiles, and those things are unrelenting the way we're supposed to be. And so he ran right into his eye. Do you remember that? And it was going to try to be a bad, you know, the devil had a plan.
Anything. You called it out.
You had no idea. And we were with God from the beginning, not insurance. And so we were very thankful. And I think there were a couple of times things like that, and you may not have ever known that, but we did. So we're thankful. And because military people are quiet sometimes, right? They don't tell you everything. And Joe Jean would nod probably. So we're thankful.
Well, all I had to add was that I'll get to see the two of y'all always work as a team. Yeah. And that's what we always try and do too. So,
amen. Yep. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Oh, Jordan, that was funny. Yeah. Well, what do we say? We've been together many years, many years. Oh, boy. Well, I wouldn't trade you in either. You know, from a ministry standpoint, many see pastor. Behind the pulpit, he's more visible. And as Pastor Darlene sits there, many think that she just sits there. But she does. It's such a good team because one usually is more visible where the other one does a lot more behind the scenes. And so we have a good team as our pastors. From a family standpoint, we're like anybody else, but in the end, we love each other, and we're for each other. You've always been good to my grandkids, my kids. Maybe I prophesied that. So, I mean, my goodness, I wouldn't trade you in either. You're wonderful. You're a loving, kind, patient woman of God.
Amen. Amen.
I know.
Yeah. In the words of my son, so many things I could say. Good mom. And thank you for praying all those years for the perfect wife, for me.
You're welcome.
Yeah. And we had a lot of fun times when I was little. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And, yeah. It was good times. Good times. Drove to Michigan. Once was enough. Little car. Yeah. But, yeah. Thank you for being a good mom and a good grandma. Yeah. We love you. Love you very much.
Anybody else? Praise God. Paul and James, would you move this pulpit? Hallelujah. Pastor Darlene, would you come up here? Somebody get some offering buckets. Put one here. Put it on that. Yeah. You want to show the video? Okay.
Really? Thank you.
So, Pastor Darlene told me to tell y'all, but that what we were sharing with each other to eat was not cake. It was Jell-O. The people that did the cake were from Wichita, and on the way to Tulsa, the radiator went out, and it was the middle of summer, like pretty hot, and the cake just didn't get there in time. And so we had some Jell-O, so we took the Jell-O, and isn't that right? Huh? It had peaches in it. The Jell-O had peaches in it, folks. My wife is very detailed, you know. To me, it was Jell-O. But to her, it was Jell-O with peaches in it. So, yeah. I think the best picture I've seen that album, the best picture is us three together. To me. Glory. So anyway, I know there's a lot of you want to just thank Pastor Darlene. You didn't want to come up. You're just not or whatever, and some of you got cards. So I'm going to have Pastor Darlene come up. If you'd like to come up and just thank her, just say something to her, sweet or whatever. Hallelujah. Honey, would you come up here? Todd, would you come up and help your mother? And you can come like you always do, get on that side and come up. And he's worthy.
said he's worthy to receive. You know he's worthy to receive all our praise today.
Hallelujah! miracle signs and wonders in the last days. Miracle signs and wonders in the last days. So let us give God. So let us give God. So let us give God. All
I want to say something. I just wanted to prefer Pastor Darlene over myself. I just wanted to all to her, because usually when we're there, it's me, because you see me more. I just wanted her, because it says in the Bible, prefer others more highly than yourself. So I just wanted to prefer her tonight. And we have something else for you, Pastor Darlene. We'll set them down here, and then somebody will help get them out.
Oh, thank you. Oh, those are beautiful. Oh, I know Don put them together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He did.
Oh, thank you.
He did.
Beautiful.
He did put them together.
Oh.
Wow. Thank you, Donald.
They're beautiful.
My. Wow. So anyway, we're going to GC, short for Golden Corral, and we'd like for you all to join us there if you'd like to come. I mean, and we'll have fellowship with all of you. We'll make sure we do, and thank you for being here. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you for blessing Pastor Darlene.
Amen. Thank you very much.
I just want to say thank you for being faithful, for praying me through school, into marriage, and throughout. Thank you. Everybody stand with me. Turn to somebody and say, God is good to me.
God is good to me.
Hallelujah.